A healthier group you could never ask for. I'm telling you like it is. Okay.
Roll playback on camera.
Did I ever touch you on the cheek? Say that you were mine. Thank you for the smile. Did I ever?
We'll have all the lights off. And just for a blip of a second, I'll just flip on the back light there, okay?
The way I understand the theory behind how Dean Chamberlain works is that in the beginnings of photography, people took out a camera, what was called a camera obscura, which is a little device that had a lens on the front, and they took it out when they were going to go sketching or painting, and they'd point it and the lens at the tree they wanted to sketch, say for instance, and then the image would appear on the top of the camera on a big plate. Then they put a bit of tracing paper over that and they'd trace the picture, so it was really to help them get exactly the shape of the tree. Then someone had the bright idea and said, well, why don't we get light to burn into the paper itself to save us having to trace it? So for that we'd need some light sensitive paper. So once they figured that out, photography was born.
Did you ever take me in your arms, look me in the eye, and tell me that
you're in the middle of a swoon. A swoon.
But the thing is, in early days, because they just didn't have as sophisticated stuff as we've got now, what they used to do was you'd have to sit there for about 15 minutes in the old-fashioned Victorian pictures, and you didn't have to move, because if you moved, it would blur the image. So consequently, any old pictures you see of Paris or London or any of those old places appear to never have any people in the streets or any horse and carriages or any bikes or anything, because all those people were moving fast, and so they never registered on the film, because anything had to sit there for 15 minutes. The only thing that registered would be the old tramp who fell asleep in the doorway, and he'd be there for 15 minutes, so he'd register on the film. So if you think of that idea and bring it up to date, what Dean does is he gets all the lights out in the room first of all.
Okay, kill the lights, please.
Then he opens the camera, so there's no light going into the camera. Then he walks into the shot, and with a torch, he illuminates the little bits of your face that he wants to see. And then maybe with another torch on your jacket, you put a red torch on a red jacket and illuminate that. So that, because these lights are lighting it all up, that's what registers on the camera. And as long as he moves quickly, like the old-fashioned photographs, he won't be seen. As long as he doesn't stand there for the whole of the exposure.
To me, it's more like painting than filming or photographic. It's because the lighting I do is applied directly by me to people or surfaces or objects or whatever in an impressionistic kind of way. Any color you can imagine, any tonality, any feeling you can come up with, you can actually turn that into light as a painter would do with paint.
Mars forever.
Still.
So he runs around and he's like a phantom. And he's never actually seen in the photos. So all you see is the light that he left behind on the face, or the little halo that he painted with light, or the extra red that he painted on the jacket. So he's really painting with light, using that old-fashioned technique of photography, of the fact that you can keep the lens open, and as long as stuff moves around fast, it just doesn't register.
Yep. Here we go, playback and camera rolls.
This one is gliding above the ocean. But God is riding upon his back. Upon the water and bright the rainbow. Faith is
I'm flapping.
You've been flapping, Tweety.
Is this a new technique for you? Have you been working with this for a while?
About 15 years.
Have you? Mm. Taking stills with it, originally, taking stills?
Yes.
Wow. Okay, where did you get the idea?
I was looking in a magazine one day and I was kind of desperate to find something that would interest me to do, and it just struck me as a thing to do, so I called up some friends and took this nice studio space and went in there and just had some fun.
Well, what do you think of the Beatles then?
Oh my God.
Is that a loaded question?
You could load that as much as you want. I could talk about the Beatles till the day I die. Would I?
Well, you've got 30 seconds.
Wherever I go, everywhere around the world, any given moment, in any place I find myself, I always hum Beatles songs. I don't know. It's part of my life. It's part of my blood, probably.